My name is Yang. Today I'm going to show you how to make the Chinese sweet rice. Like, you can find this kind of bottles with the fermented sweet rice in the Chinese stores. If you notice or you read Chinese, it tells you that if you want to live to 90 or longer, you better have a lot of these. Well, anyways, I'm going to show you how to make this. It's very easy. What you need is this dried yeast. This is my favorite kind, and I'm successful using this every single time. I can find them in a Vietnamese Chinese grocery store. I cannot read Vietnamese, but this is how it looks like. All right, each pack of these, there are 12 pieces of yeast in them. It will generate, well, it applies to 2.2 pounds of rice. That's what I make usually in one batch. And you can use any kind of sweet rice. I happen to have this long grain sweet rice at home, but I usually like the short grain ones. But it doesn't really matter. All right, here are my two bowls of rice, each 1 pound and 1 ounce. Now I'm gonna wash them and soak them overnight. I usually use two big bowls to bake the 2 pounds of rice, like a little over 1 pound in each bowl. Here's my scale. I put it on the scale and turn it on so that the scale will reset to zero, okay? And I'm gonna pour 1 pound and 1 ounce of rice in there. Here's. So I just washed the rice a couple times, rinse them off, and then add water to the rim, and I'm gonna soak them overnight. These two bowls of rice have been soaked with water overnight. I just need to pour the extra water out so that the water just barely covers the rice, because the rice is already being soaked. So you can barely see the water on top of the rice. And I'm going to put them in a steamer. I have my water boiling here on high. And I put the rice in double steamer, and I'm going to steam them for 40 minutes. Well, I've steamed the rice for 40 minutes and I let it cool down for about 2 hours. Now I'm ready to mix with the yeast. I put the whole pack of yeast in the mortar, and just need to grind it into very fine powder. Finishing this up, as you can see, this is turning into very fine powder. Okay, I'm gonna set it aside and start with the rice. I have a bowl of cold water here to help me separate the rice, because this is very sticky. Now I add a little bit, the rice is still fairly warm. I add a little bit cold water so that it can help me separate it. As you can see on the counter, I've laid plastic food wrap on the counter. The reason is that I do not want any grease to get on the rice, and also it's easier to pull the rice up later with a plastic wrap. So I'm trying to separate them before I can add the yeast to the rice. So I'm just gonna go on with this. I've divided the grounded yeast into two equal parts, because this one is, the rice here is half of the rice I was going to make. So I'm going to start sprinkle the grounded yeast powder evenly on top of the rice. I'm going to use close to half of this for this 1 pound of sticky rice. And because I'm going to spray it, sprinkle it on the other side also. So I've used about 1/4 of the total yeast on one side of this 1 pound of rice. Now I am going to use a clean container. It's very important that the container has no grease in it. I usually only use it for to making. Now I'm going to scoop it up and flip it to put it into the container so that the side that doesn't have yeast will face up. And then I will sprinkle the yeast on that side. I have one layer facing up that doesn't have yeast, so I'm now sprinkling yeast evenly on this layer, and after this I'm going to add more. The same process, scoop up the rice and turn over so that the side that doesn't have yeast will face up. So we go on like this till I finish up with all the rice. Now I have my last layer of rice. I'm sprinkling the rest of this half of the yeast on top of it. It's important to sprinkle it very evenly so all the rice gets the yeast. Now in the end, I'm going to leave a tiny little bit of yeast left, and then dig a hole in the middle and cover it with the last bit of yeast so that the rice will be able to breathe. All right. Now I just finished one bowl of rice and 1/2 of the yeast. I'm gonna cover it up and repeat the process for my second bowl of rice. Now I'm adding yeast to the last layer of my second bowl of rice. Almost done here. Dig a hole in the center to let the rice breathe. And I'm finishing it up with my last bit of yeast. All right, that's my second bowl. Cover it up. What I'm gonna do now is to fill a couple of either bottle, or what I like to use is this hot water bottle. Just use the very hot tap water. You can use any bottle also. So that we can keep the rice warm, because the yeast needs the temperature to ferment the rice. Now I have my rice ready with the yeast. I'm gonna put them in a big, thick blanket that I don't use, and put the hot water bottles with them to keep them warm. This is going to take about 36 to 48 hours. And I change the hot water bottle every 4 to 6 hours. Well, it's night right now, so I'm just gonna leave them there overnight. In the morning, first thing I get up, I'm gonna change the water bottle and then repeat the process and wait until 36 hours or so. I'll start see if there's that very frequent smell coming out. That's an indication of when the rice is ready. So it's been 48 hours. I checked the fermented rice in the blanket a couple times. I changed the hot water bottle with the hottest tap water 3 times. So 8 hours or so, I changed it once. After 48 hours, I actually started checking them around 36 hours at a point. And by now, these are ready. What you can see is that the rice is now kind of light and the water from the rice has come out. It's actually rice wine. It has a very, very fragrant rice wine smell. And the rice is kind of floating on top. At this point, it's ready and I am just going to put them in the refrigerator. They're ready to use. They continue to ferment and they're going to get a little stronger each day. But if you refrigerate them, they're good forever.